This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com. Today's question is, on the average, do you find that most clients have hypothyroidism? Well, it is very interesting that this question is brought up because first we have to define what hypothyroidism is. According to conventional medical definition, you measure a laboratory test called TSH, which is thyroid stimulating hormone. You also measure free T3 and free T4. In particular, the TSH is of most importance because it shows how well the thyroid is actually working. A low number means that the thyroid is working very hard, or hyperthyroid, and a high number means that the thyroid gland is working not very hard or not working much, therefore it is considered hypothyroid. The cutoff point varies from laboratory as well as country to country. The tendency is to have a lower TSH breakoff or threshold in recent years. And while it was in the 80s, the cutoff point for TSH is about 5.0, and nowadays it's coming down to approximately 2.8, and it may even go down some more. Well, in the case of adrenal fatigue, what we do find is that many people have a tendency to have symptoms of low thyroid. But it does not mean that they have met the threshold of hypothyroidism. In other words, their TSH may be under 2.8, for example, in the US, and the free T3 and the free T4 may be in normal range or borderline low, and even can be high, but they would not be considered a hypothyroidism. But they do have symptoms of hypothyroid functions, including dry skin, losing eyebrows in the outer one-third, slowing down metabolism, gaining of weight, brain fog. These are all symptoms that could be pointing to low thyroid function, but not necessarily hypothyroidism. Of course, if you suspect that, you need to see your doctor to make sure. And also natural compounds such as iodine, kelp, as well as the thyroid glandulars may be considered. It is very important to understand that in the setting of adrenal fatigue, the deployment of any stimulants, including kelp, iodine, and we mentioned earlier the glandulars, can have an adverse effect because you can actually throw the thyroid function from low to high and causes a hyperthyroid swing. And that is can be quite devastating. So while we know that low thyroid function is part and partial, oftentimes with adrenal fatigue, it does not mean that the person can be diagnosed as clinically hypothyroid in this state. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.